Okay, we are going to see if this improper integral converges or not. This is the integral from 0 to infinity, x over x to the third power plus 1 dx. This is a type 1 situation because we have, from 0 to infinity, an infinite interval. And then you see that we have a vertical isotope when x is equal to negative 1. But negative 1 is not inside this interval. So this is only the type 1 situation of the improper integral. However, this integral is actually kind of hard to integrate it directly. So let's not do that. Well, in that case, what can we do? Here's the strategy. We are going to come up with another improper integral that's similar to that. And then hopefully we can make a comparison. And that's what we can do, all right? And this is what we can do to reduce this integrand into a smaller one. Because we have like a fraction, let's just pick out the dominating part on the numerator and on the denominator. And when we are talking about x is approaching to infinity, let's just look for the highest power of x on the top and then the highest power of x on the bottom. That's all we need to do. So as we can see, we just have x on the top. So that's just x. And then on the bottom, we have x to the third power plus 1. If x is approaching to infinity, the plus 1 doesn't really matter. So we can just consider x to the third power on the bottom. So I have x over x to the third power. Of course, we can reduce that to 1 over x squared. And then we are talking about integral, an improper integral. So let's just put on integral sign first, and then along with the dx. And the type that I want to have is the infinity as the upper limit. So that's what I need to do. Be careful. Even though this is from 0 to infinity, but then I cannot really put on 0 right here. Why? Because if you have 0 here, let's just put on 0 right here to demonstrate. If you have a 0 right here, you have 1 over 0 squared, which that's a type 2 situation, right? Because we have a vertical isotope at 0. And in fact, this one will be divergent. This integral is a divergent. However, if we start off with 1, if we have the integral from 1 to infinity, 1 over x squared, because the p right here, the power, is equal to 2, which is greater than 1, the p test, the p0 not mentioned in class, it only works when you have from 1 to infinity. This is only a type 1 situation. We are not allowed to have vertical isotope. That's why I can only put down from 1 to infinity. And I can say this integral right here converges. And this is something that we can use. Okay. Well, so in that case, what can we do? Originally, I start with 0 to infinity, but then the tool that I have is from 1 to infinity. In order to make a comparison, I have to take this original integral and then break it into two pieces. The first piece will just go from 0 to 1, and then the second piece, I will have to start off with 1 and end up with infinity. And then for the first one, I'm going to talk about if this is a convergent or not. And then for the second one, we'll check if it converges or not. For this one, because it's only going from 0 to infinity, it's only going from 0 to 1, which we have a finite interval. And then we have x over x to the third power plus 1. The vertical isotope only happens when x is negative 1, which is outside of this interval. So this right here is a well-behaved integral, right? This right here is guaranteed to give you a finite area, so it's going to be a convergent for sure. And then you just have to write down the reason. Because we have finite interval, it's only going from 0 to 1, and then we have no vertical isotope on that interval. So included reasons along, talk about that if it converges or not. So that's the easy part. Now, I would like to talk about how can we deal with this. This is from 1 to infinity now, and then we have x over x to the third power plus 1 dx. Hopefully, I can make a comparison. And this is a strategy. If you start off with a convergent, what we're going to show is, we would like to show that this is smaller than a convergent. Because if we are smaller than a convergent, then we must be a convergent as well. Because remember, integral to be convergent means this has a finite value. If we are smaller than a finite value, then we must also be a finite value. That's the idea. So my check is, I would like to just write down the expression x over x to the third power plus 1. I hope to show that this is less than or equal to 1 over x squared. I hope to show that this is smaller than the convergent that we know. So to do a check, well, I don't know, so let me just put a question mark, and then right here, I will have to say, I want to check this inequality for x is greater than or equal to 1, because that's all we care, from 1 to infinity. Also, we also have to talk about, because if x is greater than or equal to 1, we have to make sure that these quantities are positive. This is clear to see it's positive. And if x is greater than 1, on the top right here, it's positive. X to the third power is positive, and then plus 1 is also positive. So let's include that all these two expressions are positive, so we have nothing to worry. To check this inequality, let's just cross multiply. And because they're all positive, I don't need to switch the inequality sign, you see? So I have x times x squared, and now will be less than or equal to 1 times x to the third power plus 1. If this is true, then we must have that being true. And I put down the if and only if arrow, so we are allowed to go backwards. Both ways, both ways. All right, so if this is true, we are allowed to go both ways. Multiply this out, we get x to the third power. Multiply this out, we get x to the third power plus 1. And now, is this true? Of course, because you have x cubed right here, and this is x cubed plus 1. This is definitely true. But then if you want to be more clear, you can just subtract x to the third power on both sides. And then if this is true, then we must have 0 is less than or equal to 1, which is true, right? Anyways, you just work out this inequality and just have to work out enough steps. We have to work out enough steps. At some point, we must be convinced, not just me, you have to convince everybody. At the end, you see, I have put down the statement is 0 is less than or equal to 1, which should be a pretty convincing statement, right? This should be true, right? And because we arrive at a stage that this is true, a true statement, that means the original statement must be true as well. So we succeeded to show that this expression right here is smaller than this expression. In another word, I can say that this right here is going to be a convergent as well. So I can say this converges by comparison. So I have to quote the reason, by comparison test with the integral from 1 to infinity, 1 over x squared dx, which is the one that we know to be convergent at the first place. So you write down the conclusion, and then write down the reason, and then show me the computations. And finally, as you can see, this is the integral I want to deal with at the first place, right? This right here is convergent. This right here is also convergent. In another word, finite value plus finite value. All in all, the original one must be a finite value as well. So I can say this altogether converges. And here is the conclusion. That's all.